Pregnancy is a wonderful yet challenging time for the vast majority of women. That is especially true for women with adrenal fatigue. I am Dr. Andrew Neville, and I specialize in treating adrenal fatigue. And pregnancy is a unique situation when we think of it in context of your adrenal glands, right? If we're looking at your endocrine system, there's basically three main organs of your endocrine system. You've got your adrenals, your ovaries, and your thyroid. Certainly, pregnancy is incredibly ovarian hormone dominant, with your estrogen and your progesterone levels all kind of going up. But it also is a stress on your body. So when a woman is pregnant, we will see cortisol levels going up as well. So there is this increased demand, of course. I don't have to tell any woman that's been pregnant that's an increased demand on your body, which means your stress hormones will elevate. Well, here's the interesting part. We actually have research now that shows that if you look at the stress of a woman as she's carrying a child, you can predict the stress-related illness that child will have in adulthood. Now, there's a shared circulation, right, between mom and baby. That's how baby gets nutrition, waste products out, that kind of a thing, right? If mom is stressed, in addition to the stress of pregnancy, if mom is overly stressed during that pregnancy and her adrenals can't meet the demand, right? Maybe the adrenals are a little weaker from whatever prior trauma or things like that. That mother will then borrow stress hormone from that baby. It happens kind of just after, or just towards the end of the first trimester, the adrenal glands in the baby matures, and that baby will gladly donate that extra stress hormone to mom. I mean, if we kind of project as to what's going on with that baby, if mom doesn't make it, baby doesn't make it, right? So fine, you need this hormone, like it's survival of the unit, right? That's important. But during that time, right, that baby's stress response system, including its adrenals, is like a pump that gets primed, right? This bucket of tolerance for stress that I talk about, that bucket is already filling up. The limbic system is already getting kind of wired for stress, because that baby knows if mom has to keep borrowing all this stress hormone, I'm going to be born into a really dangerous place. I better be ready. Now, baby's born, right? And it's already cranking out extra stress hormone, but mom's not there to take all that hormone away. That baby's going to be irritable, colicky, might not sleep very well, right? And now mom has a baby, which is not a stress-free scenario either, and mom doesn't have that extra stress hormone, so moms will often take a dip. And in this country, if that gets bad enough, we end up calling that postpartum depression. Now, quite often during pregnancy, mom actually feels better. So most women with adrenal fatigue, when they get pregnant, because they've got this added stress hormone, they will actually feel a little better during pregnancy. It's not universal, but commonly it really is. So I don't explain all this to kind of give any of my moms out there any more mother guilt than they already have, right? But it's really just to understand kind of what's been going on, because chances are this is not for you and your child. I'm talking about how you developed adrenal problems, right? Which is some degree going to be genetic, either from mom or from dad, right? But I think understanding that process and knowing some of the ins and outs and the whys, you know, armed with that information, you know, we can now deal with it. And it doesn't matter if your adrenal problem started in utero, like most of us did. You can still fix that. You know, we just have to know what we're dealing with, shift this physiology. So this connection between pregnancy and the adrenals, between ovarian hormones in general and the adrenals, is incredibly, incredibly strong. So whenever I have patients who have had issues around pregnancy, certainly postpartum depression or even gestational diabetes, any kind of issues in and around pregnancy, and even beyond that, even just general ovarian hormone problems, I am always going to kind of refocus and look at how are the adrenals? Because almost always we will see some semblance of adrenal problems developing early on, right? And that it's affected the ovarian hormones ultimately over time. Fix the adrenals, right? And then you don't have to go crazy chasing after all these ovarian hormone issues over time. Okay. I hope that helps. Good luck.